Well, good morning and welcome to Family Sing and Praise. So glad you could join us this morning on this Thursday. We hope that this time can be a time of hope and joy and a time of unease and unrest. If you have a shaker, if you want to shout, if you want to dance, if you want to sing as loud as you can, we want to welcome all of that as we sing praises to God this morning together. We're going to sing a couple of songs. We're going to sing In Christ Alone. We're going to sing Lighthouse. Then we're going to read a story and then we're going to close with another song. So whatever you feel comfortable with, join us in that. We're going to start off by praying. Dear Lord, thank you so much for this time we get to share together now. Be with us, speak to us, and may we just feel your love as we worship and praise you. In your name, amen. So the first song we're going to sing is a song called In Christ Alone. My light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are stilled, when striving cease. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. In Christ alone, you took on flesh, the fullness of God in helpless babe. This gift of love, righteousness, scorned by the ones he came to save. Till on that cross, as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. For every sin on him was laid, here in the death of Christ I live. There in the ground, his body lay, light of the world by darkness slain, then bursting forth in glorious day, up from the grave he rose again. And as he stands in victory, since curse has lost its grip on me, for I am his and he is mine, bought with the precious blood of Christ. No guilt in life, no fear in death, this is the power of Christ in me. From life's first cry to final breath, Jesus commands my destiny. No power of hell, no scheme of man, can never pluck me from his hand. Till he returns or calls me home, here in the power of Christ I'll stand. Excellent. And the other song we're going to be singing is a song called My Lighthouse. Maybe look at that face.
That bunny. That way bunny.
Yeah. Do you want to do some dancing?
Yeah.
Go on. In my wrestling and in my doubts, in my failures you won't walk out. Great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Oh, you are the peace in my troubled sea. In the silence you won't let go, in the questions your truth will hold. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Oh, you are the peace in my troubled sea. My lighthouse, shining in the darkness, I will follow you. My lighthouse, I will trust the promise that you will carry me safe to shore, safe to shore, safe to shore, safe to shore. I won't fear what tomorrow brings. With each morning I'll rise and sing. My God's love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Whoa. You are the peace in my troubled sea. My lighthouse, shining in the darkness, I will follow you. Oh, my lighthouse, I will trust the promise that you will carry me safe to shore. Whoa, safe to shore. Whoa, safe to shore. Whoa, safe to shore. Fire before us, you're the brightest. You will lead us through the storms. Fire before us, you're the brightest. You will lead us through the storms. My lighthouse, shining in the darkness, I will follow you. Oh, my lighthouse, I will trust the promise. You will carry me safe to shore. Oh, safe to shore. Whoa, safe to shore. Whoa, safe to shore. Well, that was great. We're going to sing a story together now, as we always do. This story is actually a meaningful story because it is Maundy Thursday technically today. And so we're going to read the story of Jesus' last supper with his disciples and him washing his disciples' feet. We're going to read from the Jesus Storybook Bible. And as always, if you want any more resources like devotionals or crafts or videos, you can get those on our website, mhbc.ca/resources. Excellent. It was Passover, the time when God's people remembered how God had rescued them from being slaves in Egypt. Every year they killed a lamb and ate it. The lamb died instead of us, they would say. But this Passover, God was getting ready for an even greater rescue. Jesus and his friends were having the Passover meal together in an upstairs room. But Jesus' friends were arguing. What about? They were arguing about stinky feet. Stinky feet. Yes, that's right. Stinky feet. Now, the thing about feet back then was that people didn't wear shoes. They only wore sandals, which might not sound unusual, except that the streets in those days were dirty. I don't mean just dusty dirty. I mean really stinky dirty, with all those cows and horses everywhere. You can imagine the stuff on the street that ended up on their feet. So anyway, someone had to wash away the dirt, but it was a dreadful job. Who on earth would ever dream of volunteering to do it? Only the lowliest servant. I'm not the servant, Peter said. Nor am I, said Matthew. Quietly, Jesus got up from the table, took off his robe, picked up a basin of water, knelt down, and started to wash his friend's feet. You can't, Peter said. He didn't understand about Jesus being the servant king. If you don't let me wash away the dirt, Peter, Jesus said, you can't be close to me. Jesus knew that what people needed most was to be clean on the inside. All the dirt on their feet was nothing compared to the sin inside their hearts. Then wash me, Lord, Peter said, tears filling his eyes. All of me. One by one, Jesus washed everyone's feet. I'm doing this because I love you, Jesus explained. Do this for each other. Now, one of Jesus' friends had made a bad plan. No one else knew what the bad plan was, but Jesus knew, and so did Judas. Judas was going to help the leaders capture Jesus for 30 pieces of silver. "Go on, Judas," Jesus said, and Judas got up from the meal, left the room, and walked out into the night. Then Jesus picked up some bread and broke it. He gave it to his friends. He picked up a cup of wine and thanked God for it. He poured it out and shared it. "My body is like this bread. It will break," Jesus told them. "This cup of wine is like my blood. It will pour out. But this is how God will rescue the whole world. My life will break and God's broken world will mend. My heart will tear apart and your hearts will heal. Just as the Passover lamb died, so now I will die instead of you. My blood will wash away all of your sins and you will be clean on the inside, in your hearts. So whenever you eat and drink, remember," Jesus said, "I've rescued you." Jesus knew it was nearly time for him to leave the world and go back to God. "I won't be with you long," he said. "You're going to be very sad, but God's helper will come and then you'll be filled up with a forever happiness that won't ever leave. So don't be afraid. You're my friends and I love you." Then they sang their favorite song and walked up to their favorite place, an olive garden. Okay, did you enjoy that story? Yeah, that was good. We're going to close.
That was fun.
We're going to close now by singing a song called Hosanna, which we would have sung, which we did sing this last Sunday, with it being Palm Sunday. But someone asked for it, so I wanted to sing it now. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Lord, we lift up your name with hearts full of praise. Be exalted, O Lord my God, Hosanna in the highest. Glory, glory, glory to the King of Kings. Glory, glory, glory to the King of Kings. Lord, we lift up your name with hearts full of praise. Be exalted, O Lord my God. Glory to the King of Kings. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Lord, we lift up your name with hearts full of praise. Be exalted, O Lord my God, Hosanna in the highest. We're just going to pray for you as we close now. Lord, I just pray for anyone watching this morning or anyone watching later, that you would just be with them, that your joy and your peace and your hope, particularly in this time, would fill them. May they know your comfort and your grace and your goodness. We pray for those serving in hospitals. We pray for those who are serving in grocery shops, those in social services, and all the other jobs that are still running, so that the world, that our lives can continue to move forward, and those jobs that continue to help us and fight the disease, the virus that we are dealing with. Lord, just pray for your healing on those who are sick and your comfort for families that are grieving. In your name we pray. Amen. Thank you so much for joining us, and we look forward to seeing you again tomorrow. High five.